In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use SEO by Yoast to create SEO-friendly content for your website. All right, let's get started. After you've installed SEO by Yoast, inside the Publish box, you will now see your SEO status. As you can see, mine is green, which means everything is good. Keep in mind that this is just a guide, so even if you end up with a yellow, then that's okay too. It's not the end of the world, but of course, you should aim for green. If your SEO status is any other color, then I recommend you review your content and make the required changes to at least get it to a yellow. Keep in mind that you need to write your content for people, so in the end, it needs to make sense and be easy to read. This means that sometimes you need to sacrifice a green circle for a yellow one. If you scroll down to the bottom of the page, you will see that you now have a WordPress SEO by Yoast box. I just want to quickly pause the video to go through two different versions of the plugin to prepare you for the future. A few days after I finished recording this video, an update to the plugin was released, which gave it a slightly different look. Now, I'm not sure how the plugin will look like by the time you see this training video, so I want to explain the similarities between these two versions to prepare you for any future updates. In the first screenshot, you will notice that there is a SEO title and meta description box. In the second screenshot, you will notice that these boxes have been removed. The way that the SEO title and meta description is modified in the second screenshot is by clicking directly onto the text here. Another thing that is slightly different and that we will be discussing later in this video is the page analysis. In the first screenshot, there is a page analysis tab at the top. However, on the second screenshot, the page analysis is now called content analysis and is shown on the main screen instead of in a tab. As you can see, the slight differences are fairly easy to understand, and the way the plugin works will always be the same. Now that we got this out of the way, let's go back to where we left off. The snippet preview shows you how your page or post will show up in Google. This heading writing is obtained from the SEO title box down here. And the writing below it is obtained from the meta description box. The focus keyword is what you want to rank for. In this example, I want my page to show up when people search for anything that contains multiple Firefox browsers. This little section down here shows where my focus keyword was found and how many times it was found. It is important that you put your keyword in all of the locations listed here. If your keyword is not found in one of these locations, then the writing will be red instead of green. I am now going to show you exactly where you need to place your focus keyword so that your page or post receives a good SEO status. In the SEO title, in the meta description, in the page or post title, in the URL address, and multiple times within the content. 1. Two. Three. 4. Five. 6. Take note that this is a header 2 tag. This is shown up here where it says header 2. 7. All up, I mentioned my keyword 7 times within the content. Now we're missing an alt tag. Since I don't have an image within the content, I'm going to put my focus keyword inside the featured image. Just so I can show you how to do this, I'm going to remove this image and re-add it. And here is my focus keyword again, under the alt text. Just for those who don't know, the alt text is the text that is shown when an image cannot be found. You can also sometimes see it in a little yellow box when you hover your mouse over an image. In terms of SEO, crawlers cannot actually see images, so they use the alt text to determine what the image is about. Now, scroll back down to the WordPress SEO by Yoast box, and near the top of the box, you will see Page Analysis. Now, if you click on it, you are shown all the things that you have done well and all the things you can improve on. Again, yellows are not so bad, and even though I have a few yellows here, I managed to get an overall score of green. This was shown at the start of this video. If you have any reds, or any oranges, you definitely need to make some changes. But if you have written nicely structured content and place your focus keyword in the same places that I place mine, then you shouldn't have a problem. As I have an overall green SEO status, I'm going to leave this post as it is and not bother with those 4 yellow circles. Again, this is just a guide. And just because you have a green overall SEO status on every single page, it doesn't mean that you will rank on the first page of Google. The guide the plugin provides will help you create SEO-friendly content, so it is possible for you to rank on the first page of Google if you combine it with the other SEO ranking factors. Now, before we finish this training video, I just want to let you know that this video is actually part of my SEO training series that I created for people who use WordPress and want to learn SEO in the shortest amount of time possible. So if you found this video useful, then I believe that you would truly benefit from watching my SEO training series. For more information, simply click the writing on the screen.